is what democracy looks like.
Fridays for Future protests bring together young activists known as strikers, demanding action on climate change.
The older generation, especially in America, is not acknowledging the issue as an issue that it is, and that itself is very detrimental to this movement because it's preventing children from gaining the momentum they need.
Kokar and others have been galvanized by 16-year-old Greta Thunberg from Sweden, who started a movement called Fridays for Future last year to raise awareness internationally about climate change. Sweden supports the movement.
We always try to raise awareness on sustainability and environment. It has been a main topic for Sweden since the 60s, and we are aiming to be the first fossil-free country in the world.
Fridays for Future activists demonstrate on Fridays, calling on governments to enact climate change policies.
I think that older generations have really not understood the urgency of the issue, in part because things like fossil fuel companies and our government did so much to cover it up and so much to distract from the crisis that was going on that until now we haven't really realized the severity of the situation.
According to the United Nations Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change, or IPCC, in 12 years, damage to the planet from climate change will be irreversible.
I will be 30 years old by then, and I want to live past 30, and I want to be able to have children. I want to be able to have a successful future, and without a livable planet, that's not possible.
I think a lot of power is in the hands of the older generation still. And I think by, let's say, breaking that power cell down and passing the strength down to the youth will be much more, I think that would be the best solution to move these things forward as they are.
As Fridays for Future demonstrations continue around the world, the movement and Greta Thunberg have been awarded Amnesty International's top honor. For Sahar Majid, Kathleen Struck, VOA News, Washington.